So shortly after I arrived, a group of, these pre-existing activists and a bunch of new folks kind of came together, at first in a kind of ad hoc way, and eventually we settled on a name, which was Community Resistance. We were all anarchists or anti-authoritarians, though there was some argument that not everyone wanted to be called anarchists, so we never actually technically called ourselves an anarchist group, hence the title Community Resistance, so we didn't want to alienate people who were frightened or put off by the term anarchist. And pretty quickly, we became fairly large and pretty well organized. We used to meet on Monday meetings, and typically at our meetings, there'd be between 10 and 30 people. So we were fairly early on a pretty large group. The main focus of the group was twofold. One was doing what we called, I guess, solidarity work, which was largely strike support work, which I'll go into in a minute. And the other kind of half of it was more, shall we say, cliched or typical kind of propaganda work. So in terms of the propaganda thing, we would hold things like public meetings. We would, to our eternal shame, debate the ISO once, which is, I mean, again, it's something I fundamentally disagree with now, in the same way that I wouldn't debate a fascist, but nevertheless, I was outvoted on that one. So, you know, we'd have, I debated the Green Party once. You know, we'd send speakers to speak in universities and high schools. We would show films, we'd have discussion meetings, you know, so kind of more typical, if you like, propaganda work. And I'd say the other thing is we had a kind of solidarity work, which was largely based around strike support. What that meant was if we would hear of a strike, which typically would be a wildcat strike and hence was not supported by any union, so either the workers involved in that strike were non-unionized or the union refused to support it because it didn't follow proper procedures in terms of balloting or union membership. We would get involved in terms of solidarity with that strike. The biggest one we were involved in and the most, hence, spectacularly successful was a bunch of women workers, of course they were women, who made lampshades in this kind of factory, sweatshop, whatever you want to call it, just outside Glasgow. You know, they worked in horrible sweatshop conditions, no ventilation, no breaks, shit wages, blah, 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 weren't allowed to go to the toilet, whatever. So they contacted the general kind of employees union in Britain, is the Trade and General Workers Union. So they contacted the T&G. T&G said, oh, yes, it's really terrible, join us and, you know, it'll be really great. So they joined the union, promptly went on strike, and then the union, of course, said, oh, sorry, you have to be, for it to be an official strike, you have to union members for 12 weeks, so we can't support you. So for some reason, we knew one of the workers in this factory, or a friend of a friend. So we got involved in this strike, as a kind of strike support group. The factory was basically contracted simply to make lampshades for Laura Ashley. I don't know if you have Laura Ashley in America. I think you do. The kind of stores that sell lampshades, I guess, and all kinds of things like that. So our cunning strategy in terms of winning their strike. So these women all went on strike and hence were promptly sacked for going on an illegal strike. So the strategy was that we would picket and put pressure on Laura Ashley since they had the entire contract for the factory. So in turn, Laura Ashley would put pressure on the factory owner to reinstate the women, you know, open the windows, whatever, pay them real money, etc., etc. And that campaign actually lasted for about a year. And in the end, we won totally. So we started off doing pickets in Edinburgh through our contacts, largely through the kind of anarchist movement. So through friends, comrades in other cities, the pickets spread throughout Scotland, throughout Britain, eventually throughout Europe, and I believe perhaps even to America. And eventually there was such pressure and embarrassment and, you know, it got to be start to get into the news, etc., that Laura Ashley did put pressure on the factory and they won entirely. We were involved in a couple of other strikes, which again, we won. Actually, everything we did with Community Resistance, we actually won, which is a part of our glorious strategy of victory, which is really great. We were involved in some other activities. We did a bunch of anti-apartheid solidarity stuff. Again, as anarchists, we were prescient enough that we were wholly opposed to the ANC, so we didn't do any solidarity stuff with the ANC. But at the time, there was all this, I don't know if anyone remembers, again in the 80s, there was all this within the ANC were in exile, within South Africa there's all kinds of shit going on, including there was all these autonomous township committees that were basically taking over the townships, in effect the shanty towns where most folk lived. And so we did a lot of solidarity work with folk who were part of these. I mean, the main thing that we were doing was with this township called Alexandria, I believe, which is the main kind of black township ghetto thing outside of Johannesburg. So we did a bunch of solidarity work with them, again, pickets, educational stuff, sending them money, whatever.